before I get into this game that we just played, I guess it's a question that I can't quite put my finger on it. So I'm just going to say it how I want to say it. Why do we beat the good teams and lose to the suckers all the time? Like, we beat the good teams who have very good records, but we lose to the suckers. DK Drama, Bird Gang Sports, and we got a lot to discuss. D-A-G-L-E-S-T-R! I bet y'all Dallas Cowboy fans were sitting here on this Sunday at 1 o'clock watching this Eagles game, praying, hoping, wishing we was going to lose this game. I know y'all were. I know y'all were. You got Cowboys, YouTube makers, creators, whatever you want to call them, Boys for Life, going crazy before we during that hate week against us, talking about, y'all Eagle fans always got our name. Y'all got Dallas in the titles, Dallas in the titles. Well, go look at his title today. He talking about the Eagles. Why? I don't know. Why not talk about your bum-ass Cowboys? Anyways, we know how this thing about to play out, man. We know how this thing about to play out. Shout out to the running backs on the squad for doing what they supposed to do. Shout out to Miles Sanders. Didn't I just say it like, what, my last video or the video before that? I just said Miles Sanders is great. He's going to be good. He's going to be good. No matter how you put it, he just second-guessed too much. And as you see, he scored like a 65-yard rushing touchdown, and he didn't second-guess the gap. He took it as soon as he seen it. Shout out Carson Wentz, man. You know why I'm going to say shout out Carson Wentz? Because he took so much from everybody, even some of you Eagles fans. He took so much from y'all, and he still come out and play a good game. Shout out to Doug Peterson. Doug Peterson did his thing too. It's on, baby. We back to 500. You already know what time it is now. You know what time it is. Shout out to everybody that was praying on our downfall. You know, I was working, so I didn't quite catch the whole game. I caught what I could catch, like I was seeing it here and there. I seen bits and pieces of the first and second quarter while I was working. And then I seen the third quarter coming home from work, and I just sat down and calmly watched the fourth quarter. The guys are looking good. After all of this locker room BS, the triangle, Orlando Scandrick, or should I say Orlando Scandalous, tried to put some 2 cents in the situation, which really, it was 1 cent. He tried to put 1 cent in the situation, which really was just him being bitter and mad at Howie Roseman, because we all know Howie Roseman probably brought him back and said, hey, we want to use you and see what we can do with you. But that wasn't the case. Now, that's why his sour bit of ass got on TV yapping like I don't know what. Just mad, bro. Just for that, I don't be wishing none of that bad stuff on people, but just for that, sit your ass at home. You're done. Sit at home and wish you was in the NFL talking about his worst, biggest mistake in his career was wanting to be traded from Dallas. Man, dude, cut the jokes. Dallas didn't even want you. Because when we got you, when we brung you in, they said you was trash. They said you was washed up. All the fans, none of that phases us. This is why I say these guys are battle tested. This is why I say that. There's no other team in NFC East that's battle tested like the way we are. Anyways, no other team. The Dallas Cowboys are irrelevant to us. Y'all won 25 years ago. Shut up! 25 years ago. I don't get it. I don't get it at all. Y'all get in a lead, a one-game lead, and now look at you. Y'all won 4 games, and we won 4 games. So I want to hit. Forget the bye. Like I told my man, he's a Dallas Cowboy fan. Y'all got hot playing against us and then got cold on this bye week. Come back into the season, into next week, and get smacked in the mouth by the Giants. Forget the Cowboys, man. Forget what they're doing. Forget them haters. Let's just get on out, guys. Dallas Goedert scored one. Boston Scott scored one. Miles Sanders scored his first rushing touchdown. And Jordan Howard scored his. We eating, baby. We eating. Carson distributed the ball evenly. Everybody got a taste. Everybody got a taste. He even let Aguilar try it out a couple times. You know, but it did. That didn't work out too good. Aguilar didn't look too good, but it is what it is. Like I said, we coming in, we gonna turn these things around. I told you that locker room drama, we had locker room drama supposedly every year, I guess. You know what I'm saying? Like, to the haters, it's enough drama to make us fall off course. No, we are battle tested, guys. We are battle tested. That's really all I wanted to say, man, because, you know, I'm gonna look at the game again and I'm gonna give y'all a real, real recap on this whole situation and really give you my thoughts on where I think we stand really right now. I'm saying this because I'm going off of the hype and I'm going off of what I did see. I seen my guys can overcome a lot. Yes, sir. I seen that. We can overcome the bullshit. Mark Holmes, you can't troll 5,500 no more. It's a whole new week now. You can't troll 5,500 no more. Cowboys legends for life. Did you see that? 5-1 team whooping them? Y'all can't do that. Well, we can. It is what it is, baby. It is what it is. All Bird Gang Sports subscribers. I don't even want to call y'all subscribers no more. Y'all are members. Y'all are members to the Bird Gang. All the Bird Gang Sports members, please report to this video. We got to chop it up. You haters. You haters. JJ Triller, I seen your comments in 5,500's live stream, but I was on the road, so I couldn't really comment. I seen you calling the Bills Dallas Bills. Dallas Bills? You hate us that much? Don't get smacked by the Giants is all I'm going to tell you. Don't get smacked by the Giants or it's over. It's over. This your boy DK Drama, Bird Gang Sports, and I'm out.